Hi, y'all. This is Sandra. I'm outside, so I'm talking louder. I want to share about credibility and integrity and honesty and keeping our words. I cannot tell you how many folks I have encountered who profess Jesus as Savior and Lord, and they lie. They have a practice of lying. And I just suspect that they may not be the children of God, because the Bible does tell us the devil has children too, and they lie and claim to be children of God, but their fruits don't manifest that evidence. So, I wonder, can you be a Christian and be a habitual liar? Maybe a baby Christian, but I mean a veteran Christian. Can you be so-called a Christian for years and be a habitual liar? I wonder. Anyhow, God knows. But I just want to urge people to be honest, because dishonesty, especially if you claim to be in Christ, dishonesty is a testimony killer. It is a credibility killer. If you say you're going to do something, you need to do it. God calls us to be good stewards and to represent Him with integrity. God is not a liar, and He is not pleased with lying. The Bible says in Proverbs that God hates lying. So if God hates it, people need to stop doing it if they claim to be His. So if you're in business, or if you're doing business with people, keep your word. Follow up. Follow through. Return phone calls. And don't be waiting 4 and 5 and 6 days to get back to people and string people along. You know, if the answer is no, say no. If the answer is yes, say yes. If you don't know, say you don't know. But stringing people along and ducking and dodging people, if you owe them and you don't have it at the time, maybe you could make arrangements to pay in installments, or you can just let them know. But to ignore folks when you owe them, that is not being a good steward, and that's not being honest and of integrity or credibility. Credibility is important, people. And too many folks blow it off and shrug it off. And I know of a Christian man in business. He's just as rude as he can be. Mean. I'm like, and he got, you know, he comes on Christian Radio and advertises his business. And I wouldn't recommend him to nobody. I tell you, I love him, but I don't recommend businesses that don't practice, you know, courtesy. Because the Bible says, I believe it's in one of the books of Peter, it says, be courteous. Rude people are a drag. I don't tolerate them real well. And years ago, when I used to do business, people on the phone, the business folks you talk to at the utility companies and things would say, you know, so-and-so Miss Hicks and so-and-so Miss Hicks that. And nowadays, they want to call you by your first name. And some people may not mind. And I don't mind my friends and associates and people I fellowship with calling me by my first name. And some of the younger folks, they call me Miss Sandra. That's fine as well. But I don't have a problem being called my name by people I, you know, engage with on Facebook and things like that. But when I'm doing business, you know, I want to be called Miss Hicks. And I'm going to call the business person I'm talking to. When I get their name, I'm going to call them Mr. or Miss. And so one of them asked me one time, can I call you Sandra? I said, no, you call me Miss Hicks. I said it very kindly and in a friendly tone. But we have to set some boundaries and so forth. And you can't just let people just run roughshod over you. And some folks want to do that because they believe when they find out you're a Christian, you can just be, you know, dealt with any kind of way and you will forgive. Yeah, I will forgive you and love you too. But you ain't going to step to me any kind of way, because I got news for you. I'm not the one. So I love y'all. I thank y'all for listening, and I praise God for common sense and for intelligence and wisdom and for letting it be known that His children are not toys and we will not be played with. We will do due diligence to make sure that respect is rendered in Jesus' name. Father, Jesus is Lord. He is faithful and true, and I am grateful to have You, Lord, to abide in me and to allow me the privilege, allow us the privilege to abide in You. Thank You, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Bye, y'all.